Hello students, myself Professor Ankur. I welcome everyone for the GATE sum session on analog circuits. Today we are going to solve important sums on the topic of power amplifier. Let's start with our first session on sums of power amplifier. So this is from the GATE 1987 paper, long time back, 1 mark question. Let's take the question. In case of class A amplifier, the ratio of efficiency of transformer coupled amplifier efficiency of a transformer less amplifier is. So here we are going to take a ratio of the efficiencies. The numerator will be the efficiency of a transformer coupled amplifier, and the denominator will be the efficiency of a transformer less amplifier. So when you take a ratio of this efficiency, what value do you get? That's a question. Option A, 2. Option B, 1.36. Option C, 1. And option D, 0.5. So we have seen both the category of circuitries in the theory session. The first circuitry you can see, it's a normal class A power amplifier. That is a transformerless amplifier circuitry. The efficiency comes around 25%. And when we go for transformer coupled circuitry, the efficiency increases to 50%. So now we take a ratio of the efficiencies for transformer coupled with respect to transformer less. It will be 50% by 25%. So 50 by 25, the answer will come as 2. So the ratio is basically 2. Correct answer is option A, 2. Let's go for the next question. This is from the GATE 1990 paper. Let's have a look at the question. A pickup signal is power amplified using a complementary symmetry push-pull amplifier and fed to a 5 ohm loudspeaker as shown. So let's have a look at the circuitry. So this is the circuitry given. The specification of power transistor are as follows. IC max, that is the maximum collector current, that is 2 ampere. TC max, that is the maximum power dissipation of the transistor, that is 1 watt. Find the maximum power delivered to the load speaker if the maximum output voltage subject to op-amp voltage limitation is 15. If transistors are mounted on heatsink so that the PC max changes to 3 watt, what will be the new value of the maximum power delivered? So now if you observe carefully, the first part of the circuitry is basically an operational amplifier, and the output of the operational amplifier circuitry is given to a power amplifier, that is basically a class B circuitry, and the output of the class B circuitry is given to the load as shown in the figure. So now what we need to understand here is, since the output of the op-amp is maximum 15 volt, the output power of the power amplifier, which will be PAC, which is having the value Vm square by twice of RL. So the value of Vm will go to the value of 15 volt. RL is given as 5 ohm as mentioned in the diagram. The PAC will come as 22.5 watt. Now, when we talk about PDC, that is a DC power taken by the class B circuitry. So that is a DC input power. It will have the value VCC into twice of Im by pi. That's a standard formula. So we are putting Im as Vm by RL. So the value of Vm becomes equal to VCC. The value becomes twice of VCC square by pi RL. On substituting, you get the value of DC power as 28.648 watt. So when we talk about the power dissipation will be the power supplied and the power output difference. So PDC minus PAC. So PDC value is 28.648 minus 22.5. So the value comes as 6.148 watt. So the value of PD max, which is PDC minus PAC, is going to be 28.648 minus 22.5. It gives you 6.148 watt. So this is the total power dissipated by the two transistors. So power dissipated by one transistor will be 3.074 watt. So as per our data, if you observe carefully, the maximum power dissipation supported by the transistor is 1 watt. And here individual transistor is going to dissipate on paper mathematical value something greater than 3. So there is a definite breakdown of the transistor in this case. Now, in the second case, if the transistors were mounted on the heat sink, the maximum power dissipated value changed to 3 watt. So because of the heat sink, it was supporting higher rating. So it went to a logic of 3 watt, but still it is less than the requirement of 3.074. So even if you apply heat sink to the circuitry will have a breakdown. So overall, if you observe, the circuit will face breakdown even if the heat sink is connected, or if it is not connected for the circuitry. So this is the answer. Next question. This is GATE 1994 ECE paper. And the question is, a class A transformer coupled transistor power amplifier is required to deliver a power output of 10 watt. The maximum power rating of the transistor should not be less than option A 5 watt, option B 10 watt, option C 20 watts, and option D 40 watts. So here it's a logical answer. When we start with the solution, there is a parameter defined for a class A circuitry. So for the transformer coupled class A circuitry, the figure of merit is basically 2. So this is basic value, or you can say ratio of the maximum power dissipation divided by the value of PAC. So automatically the value of PD max will be twice of PAC. Since we are giving the load and output power of 10 watt, the maximum dissipation will go to twice of that value, which will be 20 watt. So with that logic, if the 20 watt is going to be the dissipation, then the maximum power rating of the transistor should not be less than 20. So the correct answer is answer C, 20 watts.